Dr. Nick here, and I'm with Dr. Marc Rose. Dr. Marc Rose, you have an incredible career, over 40 years in health and practicing as an ophthalmologist. And we did our first segment on our podcast talking about your actual blood on the TV screen that we're looking at behind us. And I want to mention, just for the sake of our audience, I mean, you know, that's a pretty brave thing to let your blood just be thrown up on the TV screen. We had a good discussion about it. For those of you who didn't hear the first podcast before this, or you did hear it, you might have found out that your triglycerides were fairly good, a little bit above, but you know what? 178 in the middle of the day after eating, that's acceptable. Your blood sugar was a little too high. We'll talk about that in this segment as well. Your cholesterol was too high, particularly the bad LDL cholesterol. And you shared with the audience what? That something happened about 2 years ago.
Right.
What was that?
Yeah, 2 years ago, folks, I had a massive heart attack. It was a left anterior descending. It's called Widowmakers. And 90% of the folks who have that don't make it. So I'm the lucky 10% that did. So after my heart attack, I changed my whole lifestyle, lost over 30 pounds, and with the help of nutrition and energy medicine, specifically PEMF, pulsed electromagnetic frequency devices, I was able to lose the weight, and now I exercise anywhere between an hour to 2 hours every day.
Wow.
And my whole life has changed for the better.
And you're 71 years young?
71 years young.
Tell me your exercise. What do you do during that 2 hours?
I like to walk. So I enjoy being, I have the seven pillars of health.
Yes.
And
tell
me,
go ahead.
Well, number one is sunshine. Vitamin D.
So your outdoors exercise fulfills that.
I love to do that. I have to be outside.
Okay, I love
really it. Important. Okay, lots of fresh air.
Mm-hmm.
Fresh air. Okay, a lot of fresh filtered water.
Fresh water.
Okay, a lot of fresh healthy foods.
Can I backtrack a moment? I get my fresh water. 90% of my water comes from the foods I eat.
Okay.
Okay, but continue.
That's interesting.
Okay,
and then supplements.
Supplements, absolutely.
Okay, and then exercise.
Yes.
And then I believe in energy devices, as we've talked about in the first segment, and I like PEMF. Why do I like it? Mm-hmm. It's easy to use.
Pulse electromagnetic frequency.
Yeah, so
it's a mat. You lay on it, or you can sit on it, depending on where you position the mat.
Yeah, and we even have one that goes around the head for sleep.
Mm-hmm.
We have one specifically for the eyes to reverse and prevent cataract, glaucoma, macular degeneration, vitreous floaters, dry eyes, diabetic retinopathy. Works fantastic. Okay, and then we have the devices for the whole body. And we even have one just for prostate for men. So there's a lot of new interesting things.
Dr. Marc Rose, let me backtrack, because since you're an expert and author of a famous book on eye care.
Save Your Sight.
Yes. You, years ago, year 2000-ish, published this book.
Yes.
And you also came about a theory. Was it based on your work with Sandy and Dirk Pearson, or you came about, and it's a particular, what would you call it, a phytochemical? And what are the initials? Go ahead, you tell me. It's in a product that helps with the eyes and the eyesight,
right.
Far and near vision. What is the product?
Right, it's an eye drop, and it's got NAC, which stands for N-acetyl carnosine eye drops.
Wow. And you just drop it right into the eyes?
One drop, three or four times a day.
Can I start it by tomorrow or the next day?
The next day.
Okay.
The next day.
Okay. And if I just do it every day, it'll help for my reading. I won't need
reading glasses. Reading glasses. Right.
Wow. I'm going to test this out.
Yeah.
And and it would help for distance vision too.
No,
both.
No. Just the. Just the lens problem.
Just as huge, lens though, problem. The reading glasses. Is so, that because it does something for the lens to make it more elastic or pliable? What does it
yes.
do?
Yes, so the lens of the eye gets hard, knock, knock, at the rate of 1% a year. And when
so by the time you're 70, it could be 70% hardness?
Yeah, so when people are 40 or 45 years old, the lens gets so hard that it can't autofocus. So the lens, when you look in the distance, is very thin, And then when you look up close like an autofocus camera, it gets very thick and that focuses the light. So so 20 and by the time you're 40 or 45, you need your pair of bifocals or reading glasses because you can't accommodate, you can't focus clearly up close. 20 to 25 years after you get your first pair of reading glasses, the lens continues to harden. It changes color and begins to become opaque, and it's called a cataract. And the number one surgery for seniors, according to Medicare, is cataract surgery with lens implants. And though it's a very safe surgery, still there are problems and there are some complications, so it's much better to do things to prevent the hardening of the lens of the eye and to prevent needing reading glasses and to prevent getting cataracts and having to have cataract surgery. And it's NAC, it's an inactive ingredient in all the eye drops, and it works great both in humans and certain breeds of dogs. And people take better care of their dogs than they do their children, and they take better care of their cars than they do themselves.
Yep.
So a lot of people who have dogs buy these drops and use them in their dog's eyes, in their animal's eyes, to prevent and reverse the cataracts.
Could you do it with cats? Drops in the cat's eyes?
I don't think so.
Easier with dogs. Okay.
Yeah, dogs are more human-like.
Got it. So let's circle around on that. So yeah. I love the idea. I'm going to test it out myself.
Good.
With your permission, I want to offer it on my website.
Good.
So others can benefit.
Okay. As I mentioned in the earlier episode, I have an identical twin brother.
Yeah.
And he has not used the eye drops.
Got it.
And he wears a plus 2.5 reading glasses.
Yep.
And I have used the eye drops for at least 15, 20 years, and I don't need distance glasses, and I don't need reading glasses. One of the first signs of growing old is wearing reading glasses or bifocals.
Sure.
Okay, it makes you feel kind of old when you can't see up close.
Yep.
Okay, the other part of growing old is getting gray hair. So reading glasses and gray hair, growing old.
Yeah.
And it's easier to fix the gray hair than it is to fix the reading glass problem.
Very true. So I have a burning question.
Yeah.
What if someone has the popular RK radial keratometry where they slice the eye to restore vision of near and far? Sometimes they correct for one eye where you can actually see the close up, but then you got to leave the other one for distance. I'm not sure what that condition's called. But
it's called monovision.
Yeah.
And so radial keratotomy was done about 20 years ago.
Yeah, the Russians accidentally found it when someone cut themselves
right.
with glass.
And the new procedure is called Lasik. Lasik.
Got it.
Okay. And so monovision works for women and left-handed men. It does not work well for right-handed men.
I'm left-handed.
Yeah, so left-handed men.
That is weird.
Yeah,
do we know why?
Yeah, because the women, both sides of the brain are connected, and with left-handed men, both sides of the brains are connected.
Yay!
Yeah, so most of the past presidents we've had have all been left-handed.
That's amazing.
All been left-handed, right.
So we're good leaders, we're alpha males, and whatever
exactly.
it is.
Exactly, so the Bushes, the President Obama.
I didn't know that.
President Clinton, left-handed, yeah.
We don't know. Do we know what the current president's left or right? No one knows of Donald Trump?
No.
Okay. No one's asked. I guess we can do an internet search. Okay. Well, that being said, I'm glad we departed with that segment brief area, because the reality is, you know, your eyesight is so critical to good health, and it's a reflection of your health as well, wouldn't you say?
It sure is. Now, how I got interested in writing a book about the eyes was my practice, ophthalmology practice for over 40 years was down in East LA in Lincoln Heights.
Yes.
And Lincoln Heights used to be, back in the old days, an old Italian neighborhood.
Oh.
And then it changed to hit an Hispanic neighborhood.
Very much.
And then after that, it became a Chinese and Vietnamese neighborhood.
Oh.
So it's a beginner's type neighborhood, and I've noticed throughout the years the people from overseas, no matter whether it was from Italy or all of Mexico or South or Central America or Asia, had better eyesight with much, much, much less eye disease than people who were born here in the United States. And it had to do with what we're talking about, lifestyle. People from outside of the United States then had organic fruits and veggies, and they exercised a great deal. And they had much less cataract, glaucoma, macular degeneration, and diabetes and diabetic retinopathy. That's when I began to really think hard and study on to how important everything you talk about, Dr. Nick, everything you talk about is for healthy, not only health lifespan, but health span. So we want everybody to have a healthy lifespan, but even more important, to have a healthy lifespan, long, successful health span, lifespan.
Absolutely. You know, I think this segment's so fascinating for this podcast and this particular online course. I'm going to stay on the subject of eye care, and then we're going to take a short break and get into the actual food preparation and that discussion and how that relates to your hormones and your lipid levels. Mm-hmm. So I studied eye health because Nathan Pritikin was a great researcher, and he once talked about doing, I believe there's a doctor named Banks. She had a book about practicing looking distance and, you know, close up, mm-hmm. and varying the sight, that there's a way to kind of exercise the eye muscles. Does mm-hmm. that help?
Yeah.
With vision, close and far distance?
It does, in the fact that when we look in the distance, the eyes are straight. And when you focus up close, the eyes have to turn in.
Oh.
So a lot of people have an accommodation, a focusing problem, because when the eyes are supposed to turn in, they turn out a little bit. So it's an accommodative problem. And doing those exercises, looking from far to up close, strengthens the muscles on the inside part of the eye. They're called medial rectus, which turn the eyes in. So yeah, yes, there is. And unfortunately, The lady you're talking about, an ophthalmologist, did pass away from breast cancer. Mm. She was a friend. She was a very good friend of mine, and we lectured together.
Wow, interesting. Dr. Marc Rose, you're the author of a book related to eyesight. What's the title again?
Save Your Sight: How to Prevent and Reverse Macular Degeneration.
And that book's still available. Is it used copies, or you can still get normal copies and through the publishing house?
No, it's out of print. We sold about 25,000 copies.
Wow.
And it's on Amazon.
Used copies.
Yeah, used copies. Save Your Sight.
Fabulous.
Yes.
So Nathan Pritikin once stated that there's a condition related to glaucoma that he stated that high intraocular pressure, that is a relationship where the pressure in the eyeball gets so high that there's what's called the Canal of Schleumm. And the way he described it was, it would like a screen to your house, the window, mm-hmm. that screen filters, and that filters fluids, the vitreous fluid,
aqueous.
Aqueous filter, aqueous fluid.
Correct.
And it goes through, but when that Canal of Schleumm, when it thickens due to high cortisol levels, he said, and that was triggered by too much fat in the diet, he believed that through a correction in the diet and exercise, that many people could reduce the incidence of glaucoma. In fact, he pointed to studies around the world where the cultures ate the most amount of fruits and vegetables and beans and peas, mm-hmm. and they had a virtual absence of glaucoma. And you could plot a map around the entire world. And then he showed places where glaucoma was highly concentrated. Mm-hmm. What do you think? Western world, keto-type diets, high fat, high protein, high meat, paleo diets, mm-hmm. all that animal product, and they had the highest incidence of glaucoma. Do you buy into that possibility?
Yeah, so I look at eye disease and most chronic disease as poor circulation hardening the arteries.
Sure.
And so, like, for instance, glaucoma is poor circulation hardening of the arteries to the optic nerve.
Wow.
And there's high pressure glaucoma.
Okay.
There's normal pressure glaucoma, and there's even something very rare called low tension glaucoma.
Hmm.
So it all has to do with poor perfusion to the optic nerve, usually caused by a blockage like sclerosis, like hardening the arteries.
A plaque.
Okay, in that trabecular meshwork,
yeah,
which drains in the canal of Schlemm. So it's a sieve trabecular meshwork. So that blockage.
Now I'm visualizing the trabecular mesh is more the mesh is the screen,
sieve, yes.
Whereas the canal of Schlemm is the transport river, like.
Right.
Okay, I got that better,
and
right?
And so everything that.
Surprised I know a little bit about eyes?
Yeah, that's cool. So everything that one does to increase the perfusion, just what we talked about, lifestyle, diet, exercise.
Reducing blood pressure through the 7 steps on my other podcast series and my online course.
Right, but reducing blood pressure is allowing those arteries to open up and not to be hard and sclerotic.
Right.
So reducing the blood pressure, if you have glaucoma, actually is not a good idea. So if you have glaucoma and you have high blood pressure and you reduce the blood pressure through medication, you're going to get less perfusion to the optic nerve, and it makes the glaucoma worse. Got it? Okay, that's
but okay. If you reduce blood
naturally
through whole foods diet and exercise,
there you go.
You don't have that artificial change, and it's safe and healthier for the eyes.
And cataracts are this poor circulation, not enough healthy nutrition to the lens of the eye.
Wow.
Macular degeneration, the leading cause of blindness in this country, is poor circulation going in, not enough oxygen, not enough nutrients, and a buildup of waste products, toxic waste products in the macula. That's the center part of the vision that we see. So everything that we're talking about and everything we're going to talk about helps to prevent and reverse macular degeneration, the leading cause of blindness, glaucoma, cataract, vitreous floaters, and dry eyes.
That's huge.
And diabetic bleeding in the eye called diabetic retinopathy. So it's, and if you, everything that one does to prevent and reverse eye disease prevents and reverts brain disease, prevents and reverses heart disease, and all chronic conditions.
Now the dry eyes, could that also, I reviewed some piece of literature, it was hormonal related, I stand corrected.
Yes.
Could be partly human growth hormone, but testosterone, I believe, and it may have an influence on improving eye and the, you know, the dry condition. It's an associated issue of low hormone level. Possible?
Yes.
Okay.
And for that, we recommend omega-3 essential fatty acids.
Nice.
And the healthy omega-6s.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so things that we're going to talk about, like avocados.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And nuts.
Yeah, I did.
And seeds.
I had that this morning to eat.
Okay, the healthy omegas
are
put an extra coat of tears. The tear film is made up of 3 parts. The outer part of the tears is oil, the inner part is water, and on the surface of the eyeball is mucus.
Okay.
And if you don't have enough lubricating oil in the tear film, it's called dry eyes.
Oh, wow. So these are purported to be rich in omega-3s.
Mm-hmm.
You were mentioning the 3, 6, and 9, yeah?
Yeah, so a little borage oil helps. Or black cumin seed oil helps, along with the omega-3s.
All right, and then every morning I like to put together chia seed, flax seed, walnuts, almonds, cashew, and I soak them overnight with water so they become alive and the enzymes are alive. And I mix that with some blueberries and cherries, and I eat that most every morning.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, a lot of fiber, rich in vitamins and minerals, rich in omegas.
That's it. So that's a big help.
That's for my brain health. My eyes, too.
And the eyes are part of the central nervous system.
Yeah, okay. I love it. On the subject of when a doctor looks into the back of the eye with the scope and they see little shiny crystals, what is that when they see that in the blood vessels in the back of the eye? Cholesterol? I'm told they're a little shiny
yes,
plaques
yes,
of
yes,
cholesterol.
Yes.
And it's a sign you have potentially massive atherosclerosis. Mm-hmm. By the time it's in the eyes, it's spread throughout all the capillary beds of the body, and the heart, and the body, and the brain, and everything.
True.
Yeah.
True. So the
diet related could be prevented.
Yeah, yeah.
So and reversed.
Yes. So they've done some studies at the veterans hospitals where they have a special machine now, and it's called dark adaptation. They shine a flash of light in the eye, and then how long it takes for the eye to go back to normal, mm-hmm. they can tell whether a person is going to get macular degeneration or not.
Wow.
And that if they use a resveratrol compound,
uh-huh, antioxidant, mm-hmm.
it prevents that. And it does so in a matter of weeks, not years or months.
Wow. So grapes, blueberries, raspberries, good for, you know, all the antioxidants and the rich items, mm-hmm. and certainly the supplement as well. That all makes sense. So if we're looking at optimizing the eyes, we want to reduce free radical damage.
Yes.
So I'm suggesting that maybe we take a swig of some fresh, harmless coconut water. I like to buy this fresh at Whole Foods. And I'm just going to do a short little demonstration because I think it's so important. We created a product called the Ultimate H2 Antioxidant. And we just simply take a tablet, drop it into the water. I want the camera to pick this up if you can see. Can you see all the outgassing of hydrogen? That's molecular hydrogen, magnesium hydroxide, which is attached to a magnesium molecule. And the moment it drops into fluids like water or coconut, it increases the hydrogen content by about 4, maybe even as high as 6 parts per million. I have some samples that go as high as 10. And as soon as it dissolves, like it is there, drink that down, leave the little tablet at the bottom if there's still some there, and you can add a little bit more coconut water. But take a little swig and tell mm-hmm. me what you think here for the Ultimate H2 antioxidant, selective to free radical damage, which we saw some free radical damage in your blood. What do you think of the taste of that?
It tastes great.
Yeah.
It tastes very good, folks.
I can get Roman to use it. How shall I say this? Roman typically doesn't care for the H2 in water by itself, but with a coconut water, he drinks it all day long. No problem.
Yeah, no, children these days, because there's so much processed food.
Yeah.
And they put sugar and high fructose corn syrup in everything.
And they're used to it, right?
They're used to it. In traveling over to Asia with my wife,
yeah,
the chocolate is not as sweet. The desserts are not as sweet.
Sugar, right? They're using less sugar.
Well, that's their taste. Their taste.
Their taste buds.
They do not like, the Asian people do not like the high amount of sweetness.
Wow.
In the bread, they put sugar in the bread, in you name it, in the U.S.
Nor do they like dairy product because it really inflames them. Mm-hmm. Most Asians don't use any dairy product whatsoever. Mm-hmm. Very healthy practice to not use dairy product. Mm-hmm. You know, human milk, once you're breastfed, you're done with it. So I'm going to show you something. We looked at your dry blood in the last segment.
Yes, we did.
And it had what I described to be maybe 20 to 30% free radical damage. I'm going to show you something rather astonishing. This is a patient that came in last week, a client of ours. And I'm going to show you on the dry blood, if we can switch to this image just briefly. And I kind of want you to see the effect of free radical damage and oxidative stress. In this client, let's see if I can get that focus. Yeah, I do. Okay, now remember how much free radical damage you had, which is represented by the white holes in the blood. You see mm-hmm. how much more this individual has?
Wow.
Almost everywhere you look. You see that? And if you look up in medical textbooks, mm-hmm. Which is going to be the subject at the Cancer Control Society if I get elected to speak, you see these big white holes?
Mm-hmm.
In the center, right here, of these holes, see these little beads that look like shiny, like opaque, how would I describe them, as kind of a highlighted glossy bead? Those are what's called sialic acid beads. I almost always, when I see hope for cancer patients, stage 3 and 4, I see that all the time. Particularly if they've been under chemotherapy and radiation, they have massive free radical damage. This particular client, if it was me, I would send off the sample. I talked to his son, who's a doctor, and I'm going to talk to the doctor in charge, because I'm not an MD and I don't order tests, I don't diagnose, but I do screenings. And I looked at this, and if it was me, I'd send it off to Emil Chandel in Florida, who does a cancer profile, and I would bet a good 50 cents, and I'm not a betting man, but we would see some pathology in his tissues. When you see that much oxidative stress, free radical damage, there's active things. I've started him on molecular hydrogen. I've started him on the whole foods diet. I've got him on multiple supplements. He's 81 years old. You know, it's tough, but let's see what happens, because each person that works with us, our goal is to bring them to the highest level possible, no matter what age. I work with 80, 90-year-olds, 7-year-olds, 6-year-olds, you know, 9-year-olds, you name it. Every spectrum of the age is not immune to a societal problem of free radical damage and oxidative stress. There's so many chemicals in the environment. I mean, one of the lecturers at the Cancer Control Society talks about, what is it, 147,000 chemicals we're exposed to that we weren't to in early days. I don't know if that's the number, but it's some astonishingly high number.
Right.
And these artificial chemicals wreak havoc on the body, can cause mutation of the cells, because the outer spin of the electron travels in pairs, and this hydrogen donates that unpaired electron, and it completes it, and it helps to heal the body. Whether it's truly reversing cancer, no one can make that statement, but there's a lot of ongoing studies right now, and I'm part of helping some of these hope for cancer patients, not just with molecular hydrogen. We're using CBD oil. We're using hemp oil. We can't really call it CBD, but it's hemp oil. There's a lot of legal things going on these days with CBD. A lot of controls that pharmaceuticals want to kind of step in there. But this hemp oil is rich and free of the THC, less than 0.03%. You got to spray this in every day. Use the CBD. You want a little spray of CBD? Have you tried it before?
Yes, I have.
It's a little sweet, glycerin, but
no.
Not too uncommon to
No, some of the CBD tastes it's so difficult to handle.
You were hesitant when I was asking you want to try it.
It's a bitter taste. It's like a foul taste in your mouth. This folks tastes great.
Yeah, this comes from Holland, and we have another source from Oregon.
This tastes wonderful.
Thank you. A lot of effort went into sourcing and finding the best sources. But so on this segment, we've talked about eye disorders, glaucoma, cataracts, macular degeneration, the most common eye disorder. We know that many of them are completely lifestyle and diet related, preventable. When they do occur, we've already given you some great suggestions that you'll be able to find on our website. Some of the things like CBD you can't really order on the website right now. I believe on our medical site, docnutrients.com, it's going to be available there. But I just have to say that be open to the possibility that progressive ideas like molecular H2 hydrogen to help reduce free radical damage and oxidative stress. Do you think with the eyes there's some issue with oxidative stress and free radical damage?
Yes.
Okay.
And you might mention to the folks that in a lot of this hydrogen is being studied extensively in Japan.
Yes, huge, 500 medical journals out already.
And so this is almost like standard medical care in other parts of the world.
Yes.
I was talking with some European physicians, and they said alternative medicine in the United States, holistic medicine, is standard medical care in Europe.
Wow.
It's standard medical care. So they learn about nutrition. When I went to medical school, we had less than 1 hour in 4 years.
Wow.
Less than 1 hour in 4 years on nutrition.
Does that send a message to your mind? I mean, how can it not? That it must not be that important. That's why you mentioned one of the top cardiologists in the country in our other segment is telling you with your own mother who's 98 and a half, bless her soul, that she doesn't have to worry about her diet and exercise. That's even more important time to worry and to pay attention to the consistency
of
eating properly and exercising and supplements and holistic approach. And and without which these seven pillars that you and I believe in, you have very little chance of having at least quality of life, let alone living a longer life.
Mm-hmm. Agreed.
Okay.
Agreed.
Well,
very
thank
much.
You so much. This segment is completed. We're we're going to take a brief break. And for those of you brave enough to continue with Instagram and Facebook Live, please join in. I know it's getting a little late in other parts of the country, but that segment was about 20 minutes, and I'm excited that we covered it. We're going to jump right into our next segment after one brief pause.